owned by Kyoshi Daidoji, so it must tie in somehow. Business was fine for a while, but since they've gone bankrupt. They've since gone bankrupt. Kyoshi did what he could, but I guess there was no way he could save the business. The factory is closed down, and the land is up for sale to pay down his debt. I assume he wanted to keep his factory until the very end. Righto. I need you to go to the factory and see if Kyoshi is hiding there. But be careful. Tay mentioned something. I guess Red Cape's been seen around the factory. She was real excited and flapping about going there to get the scoop. I tried to tell her it would be dangerous, but she wouldn't listen. Dames. So do me a favor, okay? While you're looking for Kyoshi, make sure Tay stays out of trouble, would ya? Trouble too. Tay, Tai, I don't know. Oh. Yeah, don't make a wrong turn at the red light districts. Huh. Oh, well, since we're here, we can check out the case files so far. Found one. This is what happened last time. We met a squirrel at Ushigomi Gaiari Bridge who asked us to kill her, or interrobang. But some special guards got in the way. I had Raido to investigate the girl. He pegged her as Kaya Daidoji of Uran High. Our investigation led to her uncle Kyoshi and another man at the manor. I assume Kyoshi is after the inheritance, but he transformed and escaped before we can question him. For now, he is definitely our main suspect. And last episode, I sent Raido to Ryugu to follow up at Tai's sighting of Kyoshi, aka Red Cape. He ran into Denpachi, a rickshaw runner, who knows Kyoshi. Denpachi had his finest sister Shizu taken, alas. When we found her in the red light district, she sent us after a car vandal. Jackpots! We found Red Cape at Kurisuzaka. Except he was Denpachi, huh? Don't know what to make of the multiple red capes. Where's Kyoshi? This is J-Mega. You're playing this game right now? Awesome. How are you liking it so far? And hi, by the way. How far are you? Are you still, like, early on like me? Because I just started chapter 3. But, I mean, I played this before, so. But chapter 3 is called Dark Summoner. Oh, this guy. Okay, what you got? Ooh, fire clips. What? 10,000 yen? What? No dies. Unless I have stuff I can sell. What kind of chalice? I can sell this too. Awesome here. Excuse me, pickups. You're like on chapter 5. Awesome. Have you played I'm assuming you're gonna play this in order if you haven't already. Or what am I saying? Are you playing this or have you already played this second game? Yeah, that's what I'm trying to say. I'm trying to play this game just so I can get to the second game, really. And I played that as well, and I really enjoyed the second game more than this game, really. But yeah. Let's buy. Can I buy stuff? I can buy smoke balls, which lets you instantly escape from battle. There's anti-mind, cures sleep, panic, charm, and rage. Anti-stone. Stone for one ally, which might be useful, but that's a game. We plan to play another. Oh, that's great. You should. You're playing it blind. Ooh. Nice. I don't think I have the guide for it, like when it came out. So I would like use it like side to side. Like, when I was playing it. Should I? cut whatever I want. What do you mean? What do you mean? Oh, wait, no. Oh, I forgot I was to talk to him. With Victor's contacts, I've been able to broaden my range of products considerably. That's a good part. The bad part, on the other hand, that constant rumbling, clanking racket from the basement. Can you do anything about it? I thought you were supposed to give me something. No, I guess not. You only need to save my money. Let's go to Gomadan. Yeah, look, the second game is a lot. I mean, it's a lot more improved. Well, you'll see why when you play it. There's a lot of improvements from this game in the second game. Oh, Forge, what? Oh. What, fuse demons, katanas? What? No, I'm just spamming, okay. Lecture. Okay, Forge, let's see. Forge, is it? You wish to know the forbidden process for fusing demons with swords? Transferring demon abilities to your sword can make it stronger. Fusion between living demons and cold steel. Only I would dare to perform such a feat. The sword's power will change depending on the abilities of the demon you fuse to it. Sometimes, the demon's power may even transfer over to you rather than your blade. However, the demon you use will be gone forever. As Prometheus learned, power always comes at a price. Keep that balance in mind when attempting to forge. Okay, great. Really? So you have Persona 3, 4, Digital Double Saga, Digital Double Saga 2, Nocturne, and Shin Megami Tensei 4. Yeah, I'm the same. Yeah, me too. Me too. I played a lot of Nocturne. I had like over 200 hours in it, I think. Speaking of Forge, no, you can't. No, you can't really forge stuff to your gun. Your gun is always gonna be normal. But I mean, you do have like all the bullet types. It won't be. It won't be a special gun. Yeah, like all those, and I have, yeah, this game, and then in the second game, I have, what is it, the Devil Survivor games, I think. I have Overclock, and I'm waiting for the, I guess, the Overclock version, the 3DS version of Devil Survivor 2. That's what I'm for. And I played Strange Journey, but I don't own it, so I need to get that, really. I have the free soundtrack that came with it. But who's to know how to use tubes to combine demons, do they? It seems to be a little bit more than steel cast into a tube. I assume there is some enhancement on it. If you don't mind, could I borrow one for my studies? Yeah, that does kind of suck. I'll have to do something. Yeah, let's see. Spirits. I think I got Turdak, yeah. Let's see. A Hindu executioner of judged souls under the command of Yama, the god of death. When Yama passes his judgment, it is Turdak's task to haul the soul to the proper hell. Okay. So let's zoom in. He's got some fancy earrings. I don't know. I can't move this up or down. I can't do it. But I can just zoom in on the butt. He's got some big old femurs. And some fancy earrings. Look at that. Oh, look at that. The bigger the hoop, the bigger the hoe. Alright. I kinda wanna forge something. Orthos? Do I? No. I feel like Orthos is actually good for something. Moshuhu gives me luck. It's strong against electricity. Oh well. Oh, well, let's just leave. Let's leave. We don't need to be here. But yeah, like, out of like, all those games... Oh, wait, you already said your favorite was Digital Assault 2, I think. Or is it Nocturne your favorite? I can't tell. But my favorite is definitely Nocturne. Mostly because the environments really are pretty great. Behind that would be the Digital Devil Saga 1. I really like 2. I like more 1. I mean, 1 more than 2. Because, I don't know. The first time I got to the ending in Digital Devil Saga 2, it was just a disappointment to me, but I learned to appreciate it. I think the second time when I played it, I enjoyed it more. But still, it's like I still prefer 1 over 2. I'll be directing where people used to be. Get my drift. Okay. Daidoji Factory. Super Saiyan. Super Saiyan. Mega. Oh. Daidoji Factory. Senjuku. Hey, look at this. Do you know who this cane belongs to? You do know who this cane belongs to, don't you, Chrono? It's Nakamura's. Are you sure? He isn't usually standing around with his hands crossed. You're just naming people at random, aren't you? I certainly hope this is a dumb joke I don't get. There's no way a Kuzunoha could be this sleepy. This is Kiyoshi's cane, which means he's probably in the factory. Let's check it out. Try to obtain Kyoshi's cane. Let's go. Oh, it's Tay or Tai. Tai? Tay. Yes. Don't scare me like that, Raido. I didn't expect to see you here, huh? What I'm doing here? Didn't Shohei tell you? This is going to be my big cover story. Remember I asked you to look into that red cape mystery? Well, guess what? He's been seen near this factory too. Actually, finding the monster who's been spotted all over town. What a scoop. Don't worry, I came prepared. Except maybe I got a bad tip. I've been here for a while. So far, I haven't seen hide or hair of red cape. It was awful nice of you to come all this way. Just to help me, though, Raido. Huh? No. What? The stalls, they're floating. Oh. Tai collapsed on the floor. Matryoshka dolls. Kind of hard to cover the story when you're unconscious, Tai. All that aside, don't these dolls look familiar, Kono? They do. You're that detective from my Daidoji residence, aren't you? If you're looking for Kyoshi, he's in the back room. However, I obviously won't let you get to him that easily. This time, you'll get a taste of my power, along with the teachings of Kimon Tonku. Kimon Tonku. Words. A strange pattern appeared on the door. The key to breaking that seal is hidden inside my matrix labyrinth. If you want to meet Kyoshi, you need to find all 3 shards. Should you fail to get out alive, I'll take care of the lady for you. The voice can no longer be heard. It's a trap. What do you suppose he meant by labyrinth? And what's the scoop on these weird dolls? Whatever's going on, we need to find Kyoshi. Let's go, Chrono. Okay. I like DDS 1 and 2 to clarify. I like the first one the most, but the second one. Yeah, it's maybe feel like crap. Yeah. Tay is unconscious. Okay. Let's see what's happening.